Charge number two. You were driving over speed. So answer. I said, I can never challenge you. A sinner like me, you are right, I am wrong. For 20 minutes. He asked me to give him money. I can't bribe him. So I said, I have two things. He should choose one. Prayer or $1. Prayer that can change your family's life. I started to preach. Prayer that can bring the blessing. Prayer that can. Or $1. So he said, I want prayer. So I placed my hand on him. I said, may the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord make you great. In Jesus' name. And I left. Now tell me. Should I buy 160 again? He gave me grace. Grace means I don't deserve it. But this police officer allowed me to go. When you are under grace, you are law abiding. When you are under grace, you are more faithful. People say, yes, the Bible says we are no more under the law. Let me read it. Romans 6, 14 to 15. It says, for sin means breaking the law. So breaking the law shall not have dominion over you. For you are no more under the law, but under grace. Continue, what then? Shall we continue to break the law? Shall we sin because we are not under the law, but under grace? The Bible says what? The Bible says certainly what? It means never. Grace is not a guarantee to fornicate. Grace is not a guarantee to be a drunkard. Grace is not a guarantee to be a thief. Anybody who teaches anything apart from this is a false prophet. Let me explain. To be under the law means I don't need Jesus to be saved. Period. I can save myself. I can't save myself. I need Jesus. The law, somebody demonstrated it this way and said the law is like a mirror. You see, when women are going for function, they go and put concrete on their face. They put what? Oh, tell me. They put what? So you see them. Instead of them to leave at 5 o'clock, 6:30, they are still there. Concrete. So when they finish, they go to the mirror. The mirror says, sister, the concrete is too much here. Cut some. So that I use for future buildings. Then you get angry and destroy the mirror. The first person I will ask you, can the mirror clean the pancake in the woman's face? Has the mirror committed a crime by saying that there is pancake too much on your left side? Has he committed a crime? The law is like a mirror. When I go to the law tells me, TK Mensah, you are a thief, you are a liar, you are adulterer, you are a witch, you are a wizard. He tells me who I am. The mirror cannot lie. But it can't change me. Those who are against the law and say because of their sins, they don't need the law. They are dishonest. The law is perfect. The law will stand forever. The law cannot save. Why? Because when there is a problem on my face, the law cannot do anything. The law tells me, you have a problem. So go to the Savior, and the Savior will solve your problem. Will you not say an amen there? When I go to the law, and the law says, I am a thief. Jesus says in Matthew 11, 28, say, come unto me, all those who are laboring and are heavy laden, I'll give you rest. The law tells me, I need a Savior. The law tells me, I need a Redeemer. Ladies and gentlemen, the law cannot save me. That's what the Bible says in Romans 3:31. Do we then make void the law because of faith? In other words, because of grace, it says certainly not. On the contrary, what do? We establish what? What then can I say tonight? We need the law. Those who say that there is no law, they are inherently saying that there is no sin. Because the law, if it is broken, it is sin. Sin is the transgression of the law. If there is no law, let's say it together. If there is no law, there is no what?
Sin.
If there is no sin, it means there is no?
Sinner.
If there is no sinner, it means there is no what?
Savior.
If there is no savior, it means there is no one. If there is no grace, it means there is no gospel. If there is no gospel, it means there is no preacher. If there is no preacher, it means there is no church. If there is no church, it means there is no salvation. If there is no law, there is no sin. If there is no sin, then you are not a sinner. Then there is no sinner in the world. How can you say we cannot deal with the law? The law is perfect. Any teaching that is contrary to this is from a false prophet. Join me as I end with this text. 1 John 2 verse 4. Let's read it all together. I want you to read it loudly. It says what? He who says, I know him, and does not keep his commandment. It's a what? And the truth is not what? If I say that any church that don't teach the 10 commandment is a false church. Any pastor that will not teach the 10 commandment is a false pastor. I am not saying it. I'm sorry. 1 John 2, 4. He who says, I know God, and does not keep his commandment is a liar. The Bible means what it says. Is there anyone here tonight? Jesus could not ignore sin. The penalty for sin must be paid. He could not change the law. That is why he died. He died. Look at what this man went through. He died. He died. There is a common story. I heard it for the first time 10 years ago. It's a story of a lady called Tammy. The husband won lottery. Lottery is wrong. You don't stake lotto as a Christian. The husband won some lottery. It is said it is an Ohio State lottery. $1 million. This woman you see on your screen, the story says, had a boyfriend. So she went to arrange with some Nigerian guys to kill the boyfriend in quotes. So the son heard what was going on. And the son went to the father and said, Daddy, mommy wants to kill you. Mommy has a secret boyfriend. Tonight, you send assassins. This boyfriend will send some assassin. They will kill you. The father was shocked. They went to the police. They did a forensic investigation. The woman was guilty. After jailing the woman for some time, the man came back home. Thinking about a wife, went back to plead the case and say, release my wife. She said, King, I've loved you all these years. I was just someone who fit people's car. I took you to the university. I took care of our 21-year-old son. We've been married for the past 23 years. King, what have I done? What have I done that you want to kill me because of money? The woman went on her knees. Both of them began to cry. The husband said, I've forgiven you. She doesn't deserve it. The man gave him. This is grace. This is what God has done. Grace doesn't mean we don't play the law. Is there anyone here today who want to keep the law and want to keep all the law? Raise up your hand. I want to pray a special prayer. Put your hands down. Is there anybody here who want to say, I'm ready to keep fellowshipping at the place where they will say stealing is right? Let me see your hand. I'll go to a church who teaches I should steal. Let me see your hand. Is anybody here who wants to go to a church where they will teach fornication is right? Raise up your hand. Is anybody here who wants to go to a church where they will keep all the Ten Commandments? Let me see your hand. All of them. All of them. Father, see all the hands. Father, see them. Note them. Father, note them. Father, seal this hand. Father, seal this hand. Hands down. Is anybody here who go to a church where they will keep only 9 commandments and they will destroy one? Let me see your hand. Only 9, not the 10. If you want to keep all the 10 commandments, but you can't do it on your own, you need Jesus. When we are singing this song, no matter your number, I want you to come here. I want to pray for you. You want to keep the 10 commandments? You don't have the power. You need Jesus. Come, I want to pray for you. We'll sing the song. Very nicely, I'll follow thee, my Savior. Just come. I don't care your number. Just come. Forget about the camera. Just come. I want us to sing this song. Yes, my Lord. Let's join them.
I will fall.
Let's come. I want to keep the law, but I don't have the strength. Come. You can come even here. You can even come upstage. Push this way. We'll sing it again. My first stanza.
I will fall.
Let's come. Don't stay behind. If you want to come, you come. I know why I say you should come. People don't want to say this anymore. Yes, my Lord, I'll follow thee. I will follow thee. The law is alive. It will not save, but it leads us to Jesus. Even everybody can refuse. By thy grace. Today, come to the stage here right now. Come to my left here. Anybody who got baptized today, come here. Climb up. Come here. Forget about the projector. Just stand there. We'll sing the refrain again. Or the first stanza. I'll follow thee. If you baptize today, come up. We'll go.
I will follow thee, my
Savior. Nigeria will change. God will change this country. Where thou goest, I'll follow. God bless you for your decision. Yes, my Lord, I'll follow thee. You sing the refrain for the last time. Say, I will follow thee, my Savior. I can't hear you. I can't hear you. You shed your blood for me.
Thy blood for me.
If everyone will not follow you, I, not by my power, by your grace, by thy grace, I'll follow thee. I'm making a call tonight. See, the days whereby life is short. I met my friend before I came here. I never knew he would die. Yesterday he was dead. Some people wish they have the opportunity you have to be here. If there is somebody who wants to keep the law, you notice you have broken this law. God must help you. You want to keep this law and keep all, and you want to keep it, but God should wash you you want to make a decision that you keep the law, God must wash away your sins. The Bible says in Mark 16:16, those who hear this gospel, they must be baptized. You want to take that bold step like them and be baptized. And you say, Lord, the 10th commandment from tonight, I want to keep all. Let me see your hands. You are ready to make that decision and be baptized. Yes, come. Come here right now. Don't be ashamed of anything. It's a call for those who are bold. It's a call for those who are serious about their spiritual life. It's a call for those who want their sins to be washed away. It's a call for those who want God to do something in their life. It's a call for those who are seeking God. It's a call for those who want God to do something unspectacular. Nigeria will change. The lawlessness in this country is because we, the pastors, we talk too much prosperity and we don't want to teach the law of God. If every church would teach what the Bible says, this untold truth, Nigeria will change. There is somebody who needs to come. Maybe I should say it differently. Yesterday, we talked about adoption into the kingdom of truth. You cannot be adopted into the kingdom of truth if you don't make the commitment for God to accept you and give you the power, the dunamis. The song says, and although all men should forsake thee, by your grace I'll follow thee. Is there something? Tonight. Is there someone? I'll say it for the last time. Is there a man or woman here who was not immersed into water? Washed by the blood. Yesterday you never knew this truth. You are now hearing it. Tomorrow you hear a deeper truth. You are saying that, Lord, tomorrow in the morning, me, I want my sins to be washed. I want to keep all the 10 commandments. Come and join them. We'll sing the first stanza. And that is my last call for tonight. After this, it's my last opportunity. You join for your own good. Please do. God is calling you. I'll follow thee. All eyes closed. All heads bowed. Can you close your eyes? Sing from your heart. Sing from your heart. Sing from your heart. Oh God, help me. Is there somebody? Just come. Don't be shy of anybody. Don't be shy of anybody. I am sure somebody must make that decision. Somebody must make that commitment. Father, we thank you so much in the name of Jesus. We thank you for the commitments tonight. Bless our guests. Bless our friends. Bless those who are baptized. Bless those who have taken the decision that by your grace, we will never follow the world. We'll follow the tomorrow. Lord, the message you prepared, you know. Double this number here. Let us bring our friends. We will speak law. The greatest religious cover-up. They've deceived us. When to worship you. You stated in your word clearly what we should do. But we don't know. Teach us tomorrow. If somebody is here tonight, Satan will make a way. He or she will not be here tomorrow. Cancel that plan. Amen. Bless every man. Amen. Bless every woman. Amen. Bless every girl. Amen. Bless every boy. Amen. May the Lord bless us until we meet tomorrow. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Wait a minute. You wait here. Those of you here, I want to see you here. And all our guests, I want to see you here. I have a special gift for you, especially those who are coming for tonight. God bless you and have a good night. Thank you.